Hello, 3D printing friends. Today on the BV3D channel, we'll look at some beginner-friendly 3D printing projects. I'm Brian, and you are watching BV3D. Hi, welcome back. Okay, so today we're going to see some easy 3D printing projects for beginners. I chose these because they're easy to print and don't need any special skills or slicer settings for success. And all of these are free to download and print from printables.com. There are chapter markers in the video, so if you don't want to watch the entire thing, you can jump to the things that interest you. And of course, there are links to everything in the description. So with that, let's get into it. This is the KLAMMA locking cable clip by BQ3. Born from a need for cable management, the KLAMMA locking cable clip is available in a variety of sizes, both with and without internal dividers to keep under-desk cables routed neatly. The clips lock closed with a small latch, securely holding your cables in place. Print the sizes you need to hold the number of cables that need to be held. Then use double-sided adhesive like 3M command strips to hold them in place. Sometimes you need little clips like these, and being able to manufacture things like this at home and in a few minutes is a great use of 3D printing. This is the Pocket Copter by agepbiz. It's a fun little flying toy you can print in a couple of hours. It doesn't need any extra hardware or tools or glue to assemble. How high the rotor flies depends on how hard you pull the ripcord. And if a part breaks or gets lost, well, you can always print a replacement. But always be careful to aim it away from people's faces, including your own. It probably wouldn't be a lot of fun to have one of these bounce off your nose. So once it's built, take it outside and see how high you can make it fly. This is the small clip for herb bags and other packaging by Mikolas Zuza. This is great for keeping snack bags and chip bags closed. For smaller bags, you can use just one. For larger bags, using two works great. Mikolas has a great tip. Print them in a variety of colors to color code your spices. Use red for hot spices, green for herbs. If you're mostly using them to keep snacks closed, you could assign different colors to people in your home so you don't accidentally eat someone else's chips. I printed a set of 10 of them in about 45 minutes, so they're a super quick print and they don't take a whole lot of filament either. So print some out and get clipping. This is the Super Scooper No Supports by Triple G Workshop. It's a hexagonally shaped scooper for scooping whatever you need to scoop. The description says you can scale it to any size and it prints without supports. I printed it scaled at 75% for scooping pet food, and that's perfect for my needs. At that size, it was about a 2-hour print. If you want it, you could scale it up to the maximum size your printer supports to make an even bigger than normal scoop. There's also a triangular corner scoop model you can print. In addition to handling the input side of your pet, they also had the litter scooper, a model that handles the output side. Triple G Workshop thought of everything. This is Business Card Holder 45 Degrees by Titafubaki. It takes about 4 hours to print, and when it's done, you'll have a great conversation piece to put on your desk at work. I imagine the conversation would go something like this. Oh, where did I get this cool business card holder? Why, I made it with my 3D printer. Want me to print one for you? So anyway, here are some of the model's features. Prints without supports? Check. One-piece model that doesn't require assembly? Check. Holds business cards? Check. Looks like a giant check mark? Check. So give this one a try if you want to show the people at work what you can make on your 3D printer. This is Zell's Refrigerator Note Toggle by Zelrick. It comes in two versions, one where you can glue magnets in after the print is done, and one where you pause the print at a certain height and then drop a couple of magnets into it. Then you resume the print, trapping the magnets inside. I printed the one with the glue-in magnets because I wasn't sure if the magnets I had would fit. It turns out they did fit, which made me happy. Anyway, these fridge magnets are great because they look and work like a toggle switch to hold your notes and stuff to your refrigerator. With a magnet on each side, you can stick or unstick a note with just one hand. No more holding a note with one hand while you operate the magnet with the other. Print these in a variety of shades to bring some color to your otherwise boring food-preserving appliance. This is Phone Holder by xanoy. This is one of my favorite phone stand prints. I really like the design with its multiple layers of hexagons and hexagonal holes. This can take about 5.5 hours to print. It prints on its side, and even though it has all these holes in it, it still doesn't need supports. It works like an easel, holding your phone on either side in portrait or landscape orientation. And one of those sides has a cutout to accommodate a charging cable when it's in portrait mode. On the bottom, there are 4 spots where you can stick rubber feet to keep it from sliding around on your desk. I've printed a bunch of these, so I always have a phone stand handy wherever I am. And I've given some away to coworkers when they've commented on them. Print one of these and see if you like it. I think you will. So these are 7 super simple beginner-friendly 3D prints you can make. Some are fun and some are practical, but they're all easy to do and they're all free. Which ones do you like best? Do you have others you'd suggest for beginners? Let me know down in the comments. Big thanks to everyone who supports the channel, whether with channel memberships or using the links in the description. If you liked this episode, give it a thumbs up and maybe consider subscribing so you don't miss future episodes. Well, 3D printing friends, that's about all the time we have for this one. And now that we're at the end, let's go print something cool.